In this drawing, we're going to look at the concept of layers. As you begin to work on your second drawing in Module 1, we're going to introduce the concept of layers. But before we actually get into the drawing, I'd like for you just to watch this video as we cover the concepts. We use layers to organize our drawings by features or by functions. In this particular drawing, you'll notice that we have different color lines that represents different features. Layers are controlled through our layer panel on our home tab. On the layer panel, the control box will allow us to list all of our layers in the drawing. Layers are used to help us organize our drawing and to control the various properties of drawings. Properties would be things like color, line weight, line type, plot styles, transparency, and many other things. So in this particular drawing, we have a few layers. Layers can be turned on or off. For example, if I did not want to see the equipment, I could just click on the layer or on the light bulb and turn off the layer. I can turn off different features like the flow lines. So layers can be turned on or off. If you're working on a more complex drawing, such as this architectural drawings, you may have a lot more layers. It's not uncommon to have 100+ layers for an architectural drawings. So we can come in, for example, if we didn't want to see the walls, we could turn the walls on or off. And I keep getting this warning because it's telling me that my current layer, it's asking me if I want to turn off my current layer. And I would just click on yes, and you'll notice that the walls will disappear. I can go back and turn the layer back on. So layers are used to control the properties of our objects. For example, in this drawing, you'll see in the kitchen, there are some dashed lines that represents the upper kitchen cabinets. There are some green lines that represents the base cabinets of the baseline of the cabinets. And then we have our exterior wall and our interior walls. And you'll notice that they have different colors and different line types. As you begin to work on your second drawing, we're going to introduce you to the concept of layers. Later on in the course, we'll talk a lot more about the actual concept of layers. Here is the drawing that you're going to use for your second drawing. It's titled M1-P2. On this particular drawing, we have a few layers. So if I go up to the layer control box, you'll see a list of layers. In this drawing, the current layer is object lines. You'll see here on the panel, it displays the current layer. If I start to draw using the line tool, any line that I draw will be on that layer. You'll notice that the lines are thick and they are yellow. To change a layer or to make another layer current, you'd go up to the layer control box, click on the layer name, and now that layer becomes current. So if I started to draw another line, you'll see that it will show up as red and it has a hidden line type. In your textbook, there is a section on using line types and different lines in architectural and engineering drawings. Be sure to read that. So if I wanted to draw a center line, for example, I could draw a center line and it will show up, in this case, as a magenta colored center lines. Center lines are typically used to show the center of a circle or the center of a cylinder. AutoCAD has a tool that you can use to create actual center lines for circles that you may want to take advantage of. For example, I'm going to go ahead and draw a circle, and it's actually on the wrong layer. It should be on the object layer, but it's on the center line layer. To move an object to the correct layer, you select the object, go up to your layer control box and click on the new layer, and AutoCAD will move that object from the centerline layer to the object line layer. You'll notice that the object is still selected. You will need to hit Escape to deselect that object. To access the dimension tool center to place the center lines on the circle, we would go to our Annotate tab, expand out the dimension panel, and look for a tool called Center Mark. If you select Center Mark and then click on the circle, then AutoCAD will place the center mark with the center lines on the circle. This is not required for this assignment, but it does make it look a lot nicer because it will put the center mark inside the actual circle.